Boy, you sharp, boy.
Pomer.
Yo, wait. Thinking like back in the days when niggas wore fades, suit tie caps, just trying to get your way. Trying to get your way. Trying to get your way.
Boy, boy, you sharp, boy. Boy.
Has a lot of mega big records out, but he comes from the underground raw street scene of hip hop. You've been involved with so many artists from our scene, from Rough Riders to the documentaries from Game, Mike Geronimo, from Quali to G Unit, Swizz. Needlz is here, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, what's up,
but I also gotta big up the big records. Bruno Mars, Cardi B, who else? PNB Rock. I forgot you did Piggy Bank for 50. The Nicole Bus record. When I heard that record, you know, anybody could chop up the original sample, the cream, but you took it to a whole different level and made it where it even fit my format, where we like more, we really just play hip hop rhyming skills, shit, boom bap.
Yep.
But you went in where it was like, I was asking everybody, like, yo, y'all heard this record? And they were like, I said, they're using cream and all the different twists you put onto it, you know. And shout to Nicole Bus, you know, where's she from? She's from England, ain't she?
Yeah, no, she's from Amsterdam.
Amsterdam, that's right. Yeah. Amsterdam. But Needlz, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me, brother.
Where are you from?
I'm from Lansing, Michigan.
Oh, goddamn, yeah. Lansing.
Hell yeah.
Do they have a water problem out there?
Hell yeah. Well, we're about 45 minutes away from Flint.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's just the whole Midwest kind of got kind of fucked up with GM left.
It's
and
crazy,
all
man. They still haven't done nothing about that.
Like,
I own government in America is supposed to help America out.
Yo, we paying taxes and everything, and they out there struggling.
It's crazy, yeah, man. Now, do you still live there, or do you?
Nah, I live in Atlanta, actually.
Okay, that's what's up.
Yep,
yeah.
Yep.
How did you connect with so many people? Like, I mean, again, you started from an underground scene.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, when you name Mike Geronimo and Jada Kiss, and like, you know, and then you elevated to getting these Drake records, and Cardi B records and Bruno Mars records and getting platinum plaques off of just a single.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I'm going to keep it real with you, man. I grew up off your shit.
Appreciate you.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
appreciate you.
100%. Like, you, Havoc,
Love
Pete
Havoc,
Rock,
man.
But, yo, like, when I started, y'all was the cast that really got me wanting to do this shit.
That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying? I started as a DJ. I'm from Lansing, Michigan, went to school at Florida A&M.
But that's Michigan's a hip-hop state.
The thing about the Midwest, man, is we listen to everything.
Done a full album.
Nicole's album was the first joint.
Oh, you did the whole thing.
Whole joint.
Wow.
Yeah. I got all my peoples did, you know what I'm saying? So I did like 10 tracks. One, my best friend did like TL Cross, shout out to TL Cross, Rocky, Dom, know what I'm saying? All my peoples that was a part of the album. I bring in musicians, which I think is a big part of it. Even with that Nicole Buss record, like, because there's different ways to sample, you know what I'm saying? You can take a record, chop that shit up 100 times, and completely make a different beat. But sometimes I like to really bring older records into today, you know what I'm saying? So that record, which, I mean, I did all right on the record, but really it was Isaac Hayes and, you know, David Porter. I'm just following them crazy ass chord progressions.
Big up to both of them. Their two are definitely some of my idols in music.
You said you used to DJ, so do you to be called DJ Needlz or just Needlz?
Nah, I'm Needlz, man. Back then, I was DJ Nice.
You know what I'm saying? And was Needlz obviously from spinning?
Nah, bro. The real story is when I was in college, I was diagnosed with cancer.
Wow.
Yeah, and basically I went through, it was Hodgkin's lymphoma, which was
I have family members that went through that.
For sure. So, like, they caught it really early, but I still had to go through radiation, chemotherapy. Right.
Wow.
I literally just sold my 12s, got my MP.
Wow.
I thought I was a producer, you know what I'm saying, early on, and I didn't have a name.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So during one of my chemotherapy sessions, I looked down, and I had Needlz in my arm.
That's heavy, man.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah, your blessings are coming, though, man. Like I said, Bruno Mars, how'd you go with Bruno Mars?
That record, honestly, that was for Lupe. I did that record for Lupe.
Shout out to Lupe Fiasco.
Hell yeah. And basically, I did a track, my boy, shout out to my boy Cassius. He wrote the hook and helped me produce the record. And basically, I wanted to, the song was supposed to be Lupe featuring Adam Levine, like in our head.
Wow, from Maroon 5.
Yeah, hell yeah. That's what I wanted it to be. And I sent it off to the label. And they were like, we love the record, but we're going to put this new kid, Bruno Mars, on it.
Wow.
And I was like, I don't want no Bruno Mars on this track, bro. I want Adam Levine. You know what I'm saying? But little did I know.
Your daughter.
Mm-hmm.
You have three kids.
Yes, yes.
One of your daughters is going through a situation. And I got the link to this. Is it a documentary you're doing?
Yeah, it's like a short documentary.
But it was already expired.
You got to see it, bro.
Yeah, so tell us what this documentary is about.
Absolutely. The name of the documentary is it's called As Long As I Got You. You can kind of see a little bit, like we're really early on in like promoting it. But basically, it's just showing how the dynamic between me being an entrepreneur, my wife being an entrepreneur, our lifestyle, also with our daughter, Michaela, who's severely autistic. And it's just a 13-minute kind of look into our life. You'll see us, you know, you'll see me from producing, like, in my studio to, like, in therapy with her at the Grammys. Yeah. But the next step of it is we're really trying to start this Kickstarter on September 7th. And what we're trying to do is trying to raise money to purchase a bus. And this bus is going to travel around all the school districts and lower income households in Atlanta. Right. And we're going to try to, like, help diagnose autism earlier, especially for minorities, because we get diagnosed like 1 or 2 years later. The therapy could have started earlier, and the thing with autism is catching it really early. So if you want more information on this, go to aslongasigotyou.com.
That's a dope name too. Yeah. As Long As I Got You.
And honestly, that's a lyric in Nicole's record on the Nicole on the U record.
Shade 45.